vampire and see all the lore on that show.
Right.
How do you deal with the conflicting?
Yeah. Well, it's a great question that someone recently asked me that in an interview, and they said, what is it like being the daddy of all vampires on one show, and then being a daddy on another show? And I said, it's similar, but it's different in that being the alpha vamp, he's kind of like the boss of all everything, everyone in the room, you know, monster or human. And to go to playing the dad of a teenage daughter who's a powerful witch, Bonnie. Yeah, keep the Bennett family alive. That's my whole thing. And keep the mayor alive, too. Yeah. It's very different because it's you're playing this. I'm playing the dad of a teenage girl and who has her opinion about life. I have my opinion. And I found it really, really, really cool. It was actually more, even though Vampire Diaries is a show that deals with vampires and werewolves and hybrids and things, which is, I approached it just as a father to a daughter. And I kind of modeled what I'm doing based on my nephews, how I relate to them. And they actually live in New York City, so I'll be seeing them. Yeah.
You're a great dad on that show.
Thank you. So I know everyone's like, God, Bonnie's dad is really hard on her. But yeah, I'm trying to keep my baby girl alive, you know? Stay tuned. I love Kat Brand, by the way. And the entire cast of the show is Ian and Paul, everyone, Nina, they're all great. Yeah. Yeah. Thank you. Hello, gorgeous.
Hello.
I
asked a question because I was like, so my last night.
Yeah.
My question is two parts. I was wondering if you could elaborate last night when we were talking, you were terrified about playing the Alpha Vampire.
Right.
And then the second part was like, what made you kind of be able to relax into the role and that you could make it so different?
Great questions. I've been acting since I was about 20. So I've been acting for about 26 years. And I've done a lot of roles over the years. A lot of soldiers, a lot of cops, fathers, doctors, lawyers, Cylon. Cylon. There are many copies. PSG fans out there. Star Trek, I've done a lot of sci-fi roles. And I had never, in my career, up until this point, was asked to play a vampire. Not only a vampire, but the king of vampires. So when I got the job, my agent sent me the script, and I was reading it at home, and I was like, this is, excuse my language, fucking awesome role. It really is, for whoever got the role, you know. But they wanted me to do it, and I said, it's been done so many times, from hundreds of movies and TV shows, Bela Lugosi, you know, on up to Twilight, on up to, you know, everything in between. And I had what scared me was that I wasn't sure how to make it an original interpretation. It's not just showing up and saying the lines, you have to find the character. So, make a long story short, I basically said two things to myself. I said, I want the Alpha Vamp to be 100% absolutely terrifying. And I wanted him to never really have to get up. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
unless you have to. And there's a great line in the episode "There Will Be Blood."
Yeah.
All right. Where his brothers come in, the Alpha Vamp says, you do not live through centuries of fire and ice and continental divide by jumping to conclusions. You know, he's been around forever. Like, if you were to guess how old he was, how old would you say he was? Anyway.
I would say you were like 400.
How old?
400 or 500.
Years old?
Yes.
Add at least one more zero.
Okay!
At least one more zero. And he's really, really old. He's the first monster ever on the planet.
part.
Oh, yeah.
I was just wondering what was like the kind of defining moment, like being on set or something like that, finally being comfortable, you know, that you achieved a different sort of answer than what people wanted.
I think at some point when I was sitting in the chair, and when they had me locked down in the chair, at some point during filming that day, I said, I got it. And like I just realized I found where his comfort zone was. He's a very zen, if you will, spiritual, centered, evil being. You know what I mean? Like he doesn't have to do a lot. He's very present. In his existence, and doesn't have to use a lot of energy unless he has to. So when I did Family Matters, I looked at it, I've seen it a couple of times, and I said, I think I achieved the character. I would say I was maybe 85%. But then when I did There Will Be Blood, I had a whole year to think about him. And believe me, I did. I mean, I thought about him all the time. You know, like, what would I do the next time if they brought me back? And then when I did There Will Be Blood, I knew right away from the second Guy B. You guys know Guy B? The second and I was so happy that Guy B directed all my stuff, because I don't trust anyone else except Guy to direct me for this character. And make a long story short, I knew the moment we started filming, as soon as he said action, I just